Thank you very much. Well, now this is the second largest group I've ever spoken to. And much more friendly than the first, because it was a company that was floundering. And I remember being backstage. It was about 10 years ago. It was in Orlando. And the CEO was saying, look, we're really struggling. We've had a few scandals. Things aren't going our way. I'm taking over, but I may be sued shortly. And I hope you can turn it around for us. Well, you know, I have a saying that I strive to be positive 98% of the time, 2% learning how to be positive. And I've really never mastered the 98.2 percentage. And I'm coaching now 31 years, and I've been striving for that. Always be positive is something that I'm after, and this is the first year in my coaching career I've come close to that. Because today, and I grew up the same way most of you did, trying to achieve success. And, you know, success is something special to me. It's not just about winning. In 96, we wrote a best-selling business book, the number one book of the year by the New York Times. And it took us 3 months to write the book and 3 months to decide on the title. We could not decide. The book company, the publisher, the writer, and myself sat down, and we could not decide on the title. One day I woke up and I said, I've got it. And we called it Success is a Choice. And it truly is. Everything in our lives is a choice. We can wake up a certain way, go to sleep a certain way, and it's up to all of us to understand how to be successful, how to win, and how to choose winning over losing. Now, that's a pretty interesting statement, how to choose winning over losing. Well, when you wake up in the morning, and tonight will be a good example, you're in Las Vegas, you've had all-day meetings, you'll probably stay up, network, some may gamble, some may enjoy some shows, great restaurants, and you'll go to sleep. And you'll probably be a little fatigued. And how you wake up tomorrow morning will be interesting. Because I've been choosing to wake up each morning a different way in the past 2 years. I want to let you know, although we've won a lot, and I was listening to the intro, we've had 3 Final Fours in 5 years at Kentucky, and 3 different schools have gone to a Final Four. We've won a championship. We've been a runner-up. But it hasn't always been that way. No coach can boast that type of record. Because just a short while ago, after winning a championship and then being runner-up at a champion, I was enticed into a different situation. The professional ranks called once again. I coached the New York Knickerbockers 20-something years ago. And then from there, the Boston Celtics called me and said, look, we'd like you to be the coach. Then I started writing down the pros and cons. And the pros were really about 10 yards long. 2 of my children were born in Boston. I attended school at the University of Massachusetts. My first head coaching job was Boston University. College friends, dear friends. The unbelievable tradition of the Celtics to turn that around. And I had about 30 reasons why to take the job. They just came off winning 15 games out of 82. So there's no place to go but up.